Hi there, how is it going? Welcome back to English Simplified channel. Right now we are going to cover and discuss the other type of experimental research design, that is factorial design. Well, before following the discussion of this topic, it is better to watch and understand my previous video's tutorial dealing with experimental, pre-experimental, quasi-experimental, and true experimental research design. Okay then, in order to understand this topic, I divide our discussion into three parts. They are: what is a factorial design? When and why it is used? And what are its types and how they are applied? Are you ready? Let's get started. What is a factorial design? A factorial experimental design is used to investigate the effect of two or more independent variables on one dependent variable. Pay attention to the underlined words. Two or more independent variables on one dependent variable. See this example. I want to find out whether monitoring comprehension strategy and visualization comprehension strategy affects on students' reading comprehension. So, in this example I have two independent variables, and they are monitoring comprehension strategy and visualization comprehension strategy. And only one dependent variable, that is, students' reading comprehension. So, that is meant by a factorial experimental design, in which a factorial experimental design is used to investigate the effect of two or more independent variables on one dependent variable. The next topic is when and why it is used. Factorial design is used whenever a researcher wants to investigate the effect of two independent variables on the same dependent variable. In addition, this design is also used to see whether the interaction between the two or more independent variables affects their influence on a dependent variable. A factorial design is necessary when interactions may be present to avoid misleading conclusions. Factorial designs allow the effects of a factor to be estimated at several levels of the other factors, yielding conclusions that are valid over a range of experimental conditions. Therefore, in factorial design, there are at least three points of outcomes or hypotheses that we want to prove. They are null outcome, main effect, and whether there is or there isn't interaction effect of the independent variables. Well, let's see what of these meant. Number 1. Null outcome. A null outcome is when the experiment's outcome is the same, regardless of how the levels and factors were combined. In other words, based on this example, we hypothesize that visualization comprehension strategy and monitoring comprehension strategy have no effect on students' reading comprehension. And number 2 is main effect. A main effect, or also called a simple effect, is the effect of one independent variable on the dependent variable. It means, which one is more significant on students' reading comprehension? Is it visualization comprehension strategy or monitoring comprehension strategy? And last but not least is interaction effect. An interaction effect happens when one explanatory variable interacts with another explanatory variable on a response variable. In other words, visualization comprehension strategy and monitoring comprehension strategy interact as one to give a significant effect on students' reading comprehension. And now we've come up to what are its types and how they are applied. The types of factorial design are classified into: within subject factorial design, between subject factorial design, and mixed factorial design. Within subject factorial design means, in this factorial design, all of the independent variables are manipulated within subjects. While in the between subject factorial design, the subjects are assigned to different conditions, and each subject only experiences one of the experimental conditions. And in a mixed factorial design, one variable is altered between subjects, and another is altered within subjects. Let's see one by one. Within subject factorial design. Let's back to our example to understand this. So for example, there are two independent variables, namely, monitoring comprehension strategy and visualization comprehension strategy. we want to make an experiment whether these two variables affect on an independent variable, that is students' reading comprehension. So the first step is to give pretest, that is to test the students' reading comprehension, before we give the treatment. After that, the next is to give the treatment, that is the first independent variable, or to teach the sample, by applying monitoring comprehension strategy. After that, we see the result, whether it has a significant effect by giving post-test, then we analyze the data, by comparing the means statistics of the pre-test and post-test. Having done this, we continue to give the second independent variable, that is visualization comprehension strategy. And again we prove, whether it has a significant effect, by giving post-test and analyze the data. Then, finally, to draw the conclusion, both of the datum are analyzed which statistically analyzed by ANOVA. So that is meant by the type of within subject factorial design. And the second type is between subject factorial design. In this type, there are two groups of sample which are randomly selected and assigned. Back to the example, there are two independent variables, namely, monitoring comprehension strategy and visualization comprehension strategy. We want to make an experiment whether these two variables affect on an independent variable, that is students' reading comprehension. So the first step is to give pretest to group 1 or sample 1, that is to test the students' reading comprehension, before we give the treatment. After that, the next is to give the treatment, that is the first independent variable, or to teach the sample or group 1, by applying monitoring comprehension strategy. After that, we see the result, whether it has a significant effect by giving post-test, then we analyze the data, by comparing the means statistics of the pre-test and post-test. Having done this, we continue to do experiment on group or sample 2. Firstly, give pre-test, then continue giving the second independent variable to sample 2, that is visualization comprehension strategy. After that, and again we prove, whether it has a significant effect, by giving post-test and analyze the data. Then, finally, to draw the conclusion, both of the datum are analyzed which statistically analyzed by ANOVA. And, that is meant by the type of between subject factorial design. And what's about a third type? Mixed factorial design. Mixed factorial design is more complicated compared to the previous two types, especially to analyze its data and the time required to conduct the research. However, this type is the combination of the two types. They are within subject factorial design and between subject factorial design. Well, hopefully this discussion has given you beneficial contribution. Our next topic of discussion is important points and terms in experimental research design. But, by the way, don't forget to support me by your subscribe. Thanks and ta-ta.